When you're learning to program, is it useful to learn more than one programming language at the same time? Or in fact, is that a good idea? Let's talk about that in today's video. This video is brought to you by the Learn Programming Academy's Android Kotlin Masterclass. With a massive 48 hours of training, this course doesn't just show how to write Android applications, it explains everything in detail and even includes a Kotlin language tutorial. Grab a massive discount and instant access by visiting lpa.dev/YouTubeAndroid or by clicking on the link in the description of this video. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. And we're talking about when you're actually learning how to program, is it a good idea to learn more than one programming language at a time? In other words, should you focus on a single programming language, learn that before moving on to the next one? Well, the answer is it depends. Now, firstly, I've got a video talking about goal setting, which I've done recently. So click up here to check that out. And that talks about the fact that it can be counterproductive if you work on a lot of things at once. So I think, for example, if you are starting out learning to program and you picked five programming languages as an arbitrary number, try to do that all at the same time, you'd find you'd get it would be fairly slow going because you've got five things you're learning at the one time. Plus, you'll probably find that you'd be getting confused because you'd be switching syntaxes. For example, you might be learning Java and you're getting used to the keywords used in that course, and then you're using Python, perhaps learning that, and it's different keywords, different things you need to type to get things working. So if you're starting out and you haven't programmed before, that could be really counterproductive to actually do. So what I would recommend is perhaps stick to the first programming language, at least get the basics under your belt. The basics of things like variables, you know, if-then loops, you know, decisions in other words, printing out things, all those basic things that you need to learn as a programmer, maybe then start looking at other things, you know, other programming languages. But even then, I would still question whether there's any value in you learning two things at once or whether it would be better to learn, you know, one thing thoroughly. Now, where there are exceptions, though, would be in something like perhaps Android. Now, I've got a couple of Android courses, one that teaches Android app development with Java and another one that teaches it with Kotlin. Now, what can be a good idea to do there is because they're using specific languages, you could take the Android course, say for Java, and you could be learning Java concurrently. Now, in fact, both of those courses have got a tutorial built in, one for Java and one for Kotlin. So there is a section there to get you started, but it could certainly be valuable for you to actually perhaps invest in both the Android course and the Java course for the Android Java class, and the same for the Kotlin course. Obviously the Android Kotlin course and the Kotlin programming course that I've actually got as well. And you could do those concurrently. So what you might want to do is you might do a section on Android app development and then swing over and do a section on the Kotlin programming course if you want to sort of further your skills. Because obviously in that particular scenario, learning Android app development would be a very useful skill to have, or it needs you to have good skill in the appropriate programming languages, you know, whether it's Java or Kotlin. So that would be really important. And if you're learning another framework, like for example, Apple app development, you know, iPhone and iPads, that uses the Swift programming language, so that you could do the same thing there. You could pick a Swift programming language course and an iOS course and do the same. So in those circumstances, I would say that yes, that would be useful to do. But look, if you're starting out as a programmer, my general advice is, look, don't put more pressure on yourself by learning multiple things, because it's probably not going to be productive. And in fact, it'll be counterproductive. It'll hinder you. And just in closing, I will say that to myself as a course instructor and someone who's been a programmer for over 35 years, when I'm actually sitting down writing, creating, say, some content for my Java course, and I swing over and do the same, say, for a Kotlin course, I sometimes get the syntax wrong. So I'm a programmer who's been programming for 35 years, and swinging from one programming language to another one, I still make mistakes until I get back into the gist of whichever programming language that I'm using. So if I'm getting caught up like that, chances are that if you're a beginner starting out, you're probably going to be getting into a lot more difficulty. So in general, my advice would be quite simple. Learn one programming at least to a certain level of familiarity before moving on to another programming language or another framework. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left-hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.